how does sound get from your ear to your brain? My thesis work has been focused on describing the pathways in the nervous system that process sound, and essentially, I'm looking at how structures are wired between the ear and the brain itself. To answer that question, I've been looking at the nine-banded armadillo. By examining a wide array of species from different mammalian groups, neuroscientists such as myself are uncovering common basic principles about how brains are built, as well as some important distinctions between species that have different environmental or behavioral niches. Now, I'm specifically working with the nine-banded armadillo because it's the only living species of Xenarthra in North America. Now, Xenarthrans are a group of mammals with a wide array of highly specialized body shapes and behaviors that include the armadillos, sloths, and anteaters. Surprisingly, relatively few studies of their nervous systems are available, and this is in part due to their rarity and some of the species being on the endangered species list. So our lab was headed into this project with two goals. One was to characterize the connections of hearing-related structures in a Xenarthran brain, and then two was to compare those to other species. Now, the pathway that sound signals take from the ear in the early steps involve the brainstem and the midbrain. The later steps involve the thalamus, or a sensory relay area, and the auditory cortex. We're going to be focusing on that latter portion of the pathway, specifically the MGN part of the thalamus, or the medial geniculate nucleus, and auditory cortex. What we did was we identified regions of auditory cortex by playing different frequencies and recording neuron activity that came from that auditory cortex. We then visualized the connections of the brain using chemicals called tracers that were chemicals that are taken up by that part of the brain and show connections to other structures. We placed them into either high frequency areas marked with green or low frequency areas marked with red. And then this allowed us to visualize the connections that come from structures that are earlier in the auditory pathway, specifically that medial geniculate nucleus. Generally, we found that high and low frequency regions of the MGN that project to auditory cortex were segregated, so there is a topography of frequencies in the thalamus. Now, this is similar to what we see in other animals, such as cats, rats, and mice, and is in support that sound is processed in an orderly array with distinct regions of structures that are devoted to specific frequencies. In general, these findings in the armadillo indicate that there are some common organizational plans in auditory cortex for all placental mammals, and further work may reveal that this is the case for earlier derived mammals, such as the platypi. So in short, to answer how does sound get from your ear to your brain, it is similar to what we see in the armadillo, with different frequencies kept separate along different pathways.